The European Organization for Nuclear Research is a European research organization that operates the largest particle physics laboratory in the world. Established in 1954, the organization is based in a northwest suburb of Geneva on the Franco-Swiss border, 46 degrees 14'3" and 6 degrees 3'19", and has 21 member states. Israel is the first, and currently only, non-European country granted full membership. The term CERN is also used to refer to the laboratory, which in 2013 had 2,513 staff members, and hosted some 12,313 fellows, associates, apprentices as well as visiting scientists and engineers representing 608 universities and research facilities. CERN's main function is to provide the particle accelerators and other infrastructure needed for high-energy physics research. As a result, numerous experiments have been constructed at CERN as a result of international collaborations. CERN is also the birthplace of the World Wide Web. The main site at Marin has a large computer facility containing powerful data processing facilities, primarily for experimental data analysis, because of the need to make these facilities available to researchers elsewhere. It has historically been a major wide area networking hub. The convention establishing CERN was ratified on September 29, 1954 by 12 countries in Western Europe. The acronym CERN originally represented the French words for Conseil Européen pour la Recherche Nucléaire, European Council for Nuclear Research, which was a provisional council for building the laboratory, established by 12 European governments in 1952. The acronym was retained for the new laboratory after the Provisional Council was dissolved, even though the name changed to the current organization Européen pour la Recherche Nucléaire, European Organization for Nuclear Research, in 1954. According to Lukáš Walorský, a former director of CERN, when the name was changed, the acronym could have become the awkward URN, and Heisenberg said that the acronym could still be CERN even if the name is not. CERN's first president was Sir Benjamin Lockspieser. Eduardo Amaldi was the general secretary of CERN at its early stages when operations were still provisional, while the first director general, 1954, was Felix Bloch. The laboratory was originally devoted to study of atomic nuclei, but was soon applied to higher energy physics, concerned mainly with the study of interactions between subatomic particles. Therefore, the laboratory operated by CERN is commonly referred to as the European Laboratory for Particle Physics, Laboratório Européen pour la Physique des Particules, which better describes the research being performed there. Scientific achievements. Several important achievements in particle physics have been made through experiments at CERN. They include, 1973, the discovery of neutral currents in the Gargamel bubble chamber, 1983, the discovery of W and Z bosons in the UA1 and UA2 experiments, 1989, the determination of the number of light neutrino families at the Large Electron-Positron Collider, LEP, operating on the Z boson peak, 1995, the first creation of anti-hydrogen atoms in the PS210 experiment, 1999, the discovery of direct CP violation in the NA48 experiment, 2010, the isolation of 38 atoms of anti-hydrogen, 2011, maintaining anti-hydrogen for over 15 minutes, 2012, a boson with mass around 125 giga electron volts / C2 consistent with long-sought Higgs boson. The 1984 Nobel Prize for Physics was awarded to Carlo Rubbia and Simon van der Meer for the developments that resulted in the discoveries of the W and Z bosons. The 1992 Nobel Prize for Physics was awarded to CERN staff researcher Georges Charpak for his invention and development of particle detectors, in particular the multi-wire proportional chamber. Computer science. The World Wide Web began as a CERN project named Inquire, initiated by Tim Berners-Lee in 1989 and Robert Kaye in 1990. Berners-Lee and Kaye were jointly honored by the Association for Computing Machinery in 1995 for their contributions to the development of the World Wide Web. Based on the concept of hypertext, the project was intended to facilitate sharing of information among researchers. The first website was activated in 1991. On April 30, 1993, CERN announced that the World Wide Web would be free to anyone. A copy of the original first web page, created by Berners-Lee, is still published on the World Wide Web Consortium's website as a historical document. Prior to the web's development, CERN had pioneered the introduction of Internet technology, beginning in the early 1980s. A short history of this period can be found at CERN.ch. More recently, CERN has become a facility for the development of grid computing, hosting projects including the Enabling Grids for E-Science, EEG, and LHC Computing Grid. It also hosts the CERN Internet Exchange Point, CIXP, one of the two main Internet Exchange Points in Switzerland. Faster than light neutrino anomaly. Main article, Faster than light neutrino anomaly. On September 22, 2011, the OPERA collaboration reported the detection of 17 giga electron volts and 28 giga electron volts muon neutrinos, sent 730 kilometers, 450 miles, from CERN near Geneva, Switzerland to the Gran Sasso National Laboratory in Italy, traveling apparently faster than light by a factor of 2.48 times 10 minus 5, approximately 1 in 40,000, a statistic with 6.0 sigma significance. However, in March 2012 it was reported by a new team of scientists for CERN, Icarus, that the previous experiment was most likely flawed and will be retested by scientists of both the OPERA and Icarus teams. On 16 March, CERN stated in a press release that the results were flawed due to an incorrectly connected GPS synchronization cable. Particle accelerators. Current complex. CERN operates a network of 6 accelerators and a decelerator. Each machine in the chain increases the energy of particle beams before delivering them to experiments or to the next more powerful accelerator. Currently active machines are 2 linear accelerators generate low energy particles. LINAC 2 accelerates protons to 50 mega electron volts for injection into the proton synchrotron booster, PSB, and LINAC 3 provides heavy ions at 4.2 mega electron volts/U for injection into the low energy ion ring, LIR. The proton synchrotron booster increases the energy of particles generated by the proton linear accelerator before they are transferred to the other accelerators. The low energy ion ring, LIR, accelerates the ions from the ion linear accelerator before transferring them to the proton synchrotron, PS. This accelerator was commissioned in 2005. After having been reconfigured from the previous low-energy antiproton ring, LIR. The 28 giga electron volts proton synchrotron, PS, built during 1954, 1959 and still operating as a feeder to the more powerful SPS. The super proton synchrotron, SPS. A circular accelerator with a diameter of 2 kilometers built in a tunnel, which started operation in 1976, It was designed to deliver an energy of 300 giga electron volts and was gradually upgraded to 450 giga electron volts. As well as having its own beamlines for fixed target experiments, currently Compass and NA62, it has been operated as a proton-antiproton collider, the SPPS collider, and for accelerating high-energy electrons and positrons which were injected into the Large Electron-Positron Collider, LEP. Since 2008, it has been used to inject protons and heavy ions into the Large Hadron Collider, LHC. The online isotope mass separator, ISOLDA, which is used to study unstable nuclei. The radioactive ions are produced by the impact of protons at an energy of 1.0 to 1.4 giga electron volts from the proton synchrotron booster. It was first commissioned in 1967 and was rebuilt with major upgrades in 1974 and 1992. The antiproton decelerator, AD, which reduces the velocity of antiprotons to about 10% of the speed of light for research of antimatter. The Compact Linear Collider Test Facility, which studies feasibility for the Future Normal Conducting Linear Collider Project. Large Hadron Collider Main Article, Large Hadron Collider. Most of the activities at CERN currently involve operating the Large Hadron Collider, LHC, and the experiments for it. The LHC represents a large-scale, worldwide scientific cooperation project. The LHC tunnel is located 100 meters underground, in the region between the Geneva International Airport and the nearby Jura Mountains. It uses the 27-kilometer circumference circular tunnel previously occupied by the Large Electron-Positron Collider, LEP, which was shut down in November 2000. CERN's existing PS/SPS accelerator complexes will be used to pre-accelerate protons which will then be injected into the LHC. 7 experiments, CMS, ATLAS, LHCB, Mo et al., Totem, LHC Ford and ALICE, will be performed on the collider. Each of them will study particle collisions from a different aspect, and with different technologies. Construction for these experiments required an extraordinary engineering effort. For example, a special crane was rented from Belgium to lower pieces of the CMS detector into its underground cavern, since each piece weighed nearly 2,000 tons. The first of the approximately 5,000 magnets necessary for construction was lowered down a special shaft at 1300 hours GMT on March 7, 2005. The LHC has begun to generate vast quantities of data, which CERN streams to laboratories around the world for distributed processing, making use of a specialized grid infrastructure, the LHC computing grid. During April 2005, a trial successfully streamed 600 megabytes per second to 7 different sites across the world. The initial particle beams were injected into the LHC August 2008. The first attempt to circulate a beam through the entire LHC was at 8:28 GMT on September 10, 2008, but the system failed because of a faulty magnet connection, and it was stopped for repairs on September 19, 2008. The LHC resumed operation on November 20, 2009 by successfully circulating 2 beams, each with an energy of 3.5 tera electron volts. The challenge for the engineers was then to try to line up the 2 beams so that they smashed into each other. This is like firing 2 needles across the Atlantic and getting them to hit each other, according to the LHC's main engineer Steve Myers, director for accelerators and technology at the Swiss laboratory. At 1200 BST on March 30, 2010, the LHC successfully smashed two proton particle beams traveling with 3.5 TeV, tera electron volts, of energy, resulting in a 7 TeV event. However, this was just the start of what was needed for the expected discovery of the Higgs boson. When the 7 TeV experimental period ended, the LHC revved to 8 TeV, 4 TeV acceleration in both directions, during March 2012, and soon began particle collisions at that rate. In early 2013, the LHC was deactivated for a 2-year maintenance period, to strengthen the huge magnets inside the accelerator. Eventually it will attempt to create 14 TeV events. In July 2012, CERN scientists announced the discovery of a new subatomic particle that was possibly the much sought-after Higgs boson believed to be essential for formation of the universe. In March 2013, CERN announced that the measurements performed on the newly found particle allowed it to conclude that this is a Higgs boson. On April 5, 2015, and after 2 years of maintenance and consolidation, the LHC restarted for a second run. Proton beams successfully circulated in the 27-kilometer ring in both directions. The first ramp to the record-breaking energy of 6.5 TeV was performed on April 10, 2015.